I would now request Dr. G.V. Subramanian to please say a few words.
Good morning to one and all of you. Say good morning, please. Good morning is an acknowledgement that the morning is good. Is the morning good? And that is the reason why we say good morning. If it is not good, we still say good morning because we want to make the morning good. That is the reason. That's why I asked you to say good morning again. Fine. My dear brothers and sisters and my young children, we all have come over here with a kind of a vision which we wanted to have. And that vision is just not purification of air alone, but try to control as much as possible this pollution which is increasing day by day in this Mother Earth, in this particular planet. And in a very small way, whatever is possible by us, when we do that kind of an activity, all the unified activity, collective activity, will go to a very long way. What we breathe in, oxygen. What we breathe out is carbon dioxide. And we have learned and we know very well, plants gives us the oxygen, takes in the carbon dioxide. So therefore, there is a complete connectivity between the human beings and the plants. And unless we breathe, we don't live. So for our life existence itself, it is the plants which are more important to us. And plants also has feelings, friends. Let me tell you. You go to a plant and you just say, be there with the plant, play with that particular plant, and just say in your own heart, heart-to-heart communication, I love you. See how the plant blossoms and see how the plant grows very faster than you expected. And this is reality and this has happened. Not just today. Even it is being said in Lord Krishna, in Bhagavata Purana itself, that Lord Krishna goes to every place and he sees all the plants and he says, I love you. Only once he went and said to a plant and he said, I am going to cut you. And he cut that particular plant, made it into a flute, and he was always having that flute along with him. And the plant was very happy because 24 hours that plant flute in the form of a flute was there with Lord Krishna. This is what Bhagavad Purana says. So, such is the beauty. I was told about another story. When I talk about the positive aspect of it, let me say the negative aspect of it also. Plants has that feelings. There's another story in one particular village. Tree is dead also, they won't cut trees. But they wanted to see that the tree is going away completely, destroyed. You know what they do? The entire village people will go there and they will give all kinds of galis to the tree. All kinds of negative words to the tree. And the tree will automatically die down in the next few days. The tree has feelings. So that is the connectivity between any particular plant and human being. We should understand that connectivity. We should not destroy our own ang, I would say, our own body part, I would say, which is there in the form of a tree outside, or which is there in the form of a plant outside. So we should nurture them. We should see that they grow. We should see that they produce as much as possible various oxygen, and they give us all kinds of activity. It is possible, all kinds of help which is being given by the tree in the form of fruits, in the form of seeds, in the form of whatever may be the form, all formats, it's closely connected with us. So we should see that as much trees as possible, as much plants as possible, we should grow in our homes as well as outside. We at Bharati Vidya Bhavan, we have taken up a small project in a very small way. We started off with about 1,000 seeds initially, just to prove the students that they should grow some plant. And this has been taken somewhere in the month of January or so. And then we saw that seeds had grown. we showed the entire thing to our students, how you planted it and you have nurtured it and how these saplings has come up. We distributed those saplings, and then later on 1 lakh seeds we gave it to all the students of various classes. We requested them to plant it in their homes and other places, and out of the 1 lakh seeds, many saplings has come up today. We have not counted it, how much it has come up. Almost if 1 lakh has come, we'll be very happy. And this particular activity, we would like to continue it in other schools also. So if one school is going to make about 1 lakh saplings, if there are 10 schools, it will be 10 lakh saplings. It will become a record by itself. So that's the aim in which we are all working together, so that we create a new world, a pollution-free world in the country, and in this particular city and in the country as well. Looking at what we are doing, definitely it will be taken up in other cities also, and other cities also are doing it in various fashions, and we all together will see that we respect our Mother Earth as much as possible. And saying these words, I thank you for giving me an opportunity to speak all of you. Thank you.